So the game plan for us today is to go to multiple places and taste different dishes here in Jamma Masjid. How much time will it
take? Just 1 minute. 1 minute.
Spicy mein Changezi
hai. Changezi kyun bolte hai usko?
Changez Khan ka dish.
I think when they say half portion, I think it's a half chicken.
Well, we stopped by this beautiful shop and he's making Shahi Sheerman.
Very rich. It's like a biscuit.
Thanda yeah, mein biscuit it's like a na? Soft cookie.
When people are visiting Delhi, they would visit Old Delhi, Walled City. They would make sure that they eat in one of these eateries.
So it's like a tick mark.
A tick mark.
Chicken korma.
Chicken korma.
Yeah.
Badam masala. Mutton stew.
Kya hai ye? Mutton nihari.
How much time will it take?
Oh my god, it's so hot. Huh? It's a gas tank. So what are the popular
dishes here? So I'm told chicken changezi is very popular. It's again a kind of korma. Heavy korma with nuts and all. So let's see. I've not eaten here before and I've heard it is pretty popular.
Well, our lunch continues after Kareem's. We've decided to come to this place called Al Jawahar, which is right outside on the main road. And while we tasted the korma there, I felt we should taste a biryani. So we've come here to Al Jawahar to taste the biryani and also the
Chicken Changezi.
Chicken Changezi.
You can try a mutton biryani.
They have a half plate and full plate. So since we've eaten a lot, we can go for a half plate. And then of course they have kebabs. So all these eateries have kebabs and tandoori items. It's a pretty big menu. You see the main course is curries. Moru musallam, which is for two, the whole moon. Nihari also they do, and chicken changezi is what I think what we're going for. Of course, butter chicken, people who love their butter chicken can come here.
Spicy mein changezi hai.
Changezi kyun bolte hai usko? रोस्टेड चिकन डलता है चाहे चिकन को पहले रोस्ट करके
चिकन को पहले रोस्ट किया जाता है तंदूर में
हाँ
उसके बाद फिर ग्रेवी में वो हमने बहुत सुना था बहुत स्पेशल ट्राई कीजिए सर
फुल मटन बिरयानी देना और एक चंगेजी देना
हाफ
चंगेजी देना और एक कबाब ट्राई करें बस ना पता लगे यहाँ
का
हाँ सुपर
मटन सीख कर
थैंक यू
बाकी इफ यू सी दे हैव ब्रेन करी
पीपल इज अ
भेजा करी है और आलू गोश इज समथिंग व्हिच यू नो इफ वी स्टिल हैव एपेटाइट समवेयर लेटर इन द इवनिंग मे बी वी विल ट्राई आलू गोश
आलू गोश
क्वाइट पॉपुलर रामपुरी डिश
सो द गेम प्लान फॉर अस टुडे इज टू गो टू मल्टीपल प्लेसेस एंड टेस्ट डिफरेंट डिशेस सो वी विल ट्राई एंड अवॉइड टेस्टिंग द सेम डिश सो दिस इज नॉट रियली मेंट टू बी अ कंपैरिजन बिटवीन लेट्स से one eatery versus the next but more a flavor of what one can expect to find when here in Jamma Masjid
if people are coming you know who with some friends or family members who are vegetarian so there is a decent vegetarian choice also
really
so malai kofta kadhai paneer and palak paneer dal makhani dal fry plain dal so there is a decent choice for vegetarian
for vegetarians as well
so vegetarians will not go hungry
this looks like a big meal, full biryani, very decent portion. Easily two people can share. And look at the half portion of chicken chengezi.
Chicken chengezi.
We could have taken one fourth.
Chaar log kha sakte hain. Aaram se.
Kebab first and. Unlike what we had earlier at Qureshi, this doesn't have extra fat over it or cream over it. It's just cooked on sigiri. And yeah. I'm giving you a hand ground, looks like a hand ground chutney. So let's see the flavors. Nice.
In this, I can definitely feel the flavor of the meat.
Needs more. Mm-hmm. But this is lamb. Mm. So lamb definitely would be more flavorful. And less fat. You know, the buff which we have tasted earlier, it was
coating
your palate got coated with the fat.
I think the fat good that flavor. You have in goat is a leaner sort of a fat as opposed to, let's say, in the buff.
So, eating kebab on its own is quite flavorful.
Very nice.
Very nice. Crisp outside, that's what gives it a dual texture. Again, to be eaten absolutely hot, piping hot the moment it comes on the table. With chutney also, if you see, it's really amazing. They say half portion. I think it's a half chicken. Yeah, it's more of an onion tomato.
Yeah, it's a tomato.
I was thinking they'd make it like a korma style, but
you know what? I quite prefer this. So there's a richness. There is the oil that you're seeing, but usme bhi it is light, and I think that's because of the fact that jo masale hai utna nahi hai. It doesn't seem like that. It's a very fresh sort of a flavor that I'm tasting in this.
No wonder it is quite popular.
Mm.
It's actually made it like a home style. So nothing overpowering, very delicate.
Mm.
The breads are amazing.
This chicken chengezi is certainly a dish that speaks for its reputation.
Very nice.
What I also like is a sliver of chili there. And I think this is the sort of...
This is a moda wala mirch.
Yeah, so this is a sort of chili which will not be very spicy.
Good for texture.
Mm, there's a certain fleshiness that I taste in that chili. Mm. To be honest, when you say chengezi, I didn't know what to expect. I thought it would be some contrived sort of dish. But it is a dish that is rather interesting, rather special.
Each cook has their own style of making, you know.
Mm.
So, I was also not sure what will come.
I can also taste the onion in that.
Something rich will come in terms of adding nuts.
Yeah.
And cream and you know what all they add in kormas. But this is something very different.
I think this is a little more than a home style sort of a chicken preparation. In a home style chicken preparation, perhaps you won't see the amount of oil that you see floating here. But then I suspect in this area, this sort of
oil has to be there, Kripal.
Oil has
the
to
oil
be there.
Oil is not there. Half an inch oil is not there. It's an insert. You know, at home also, people use extra oil.
So hospitality is associated with oil. Jitna fat ho, utna acha.
Acha hai aur utna aapne khule dil se khana banaya hai. Wo hai.
So basically, you've not watched your purse while cooking for your guests. That's what it perhaps means. It's chicken, yet there's a lot of flavor. Very nice. What really stole my heart in this dish is that tomato onion base for that masala. Hmm? And also, there's a certain sweetness that I'm tasting in that onion. The braised onion. Thodi si mithas hai. I find that this chicken chengezi is a beautifully balanced dish. There is a bit of the warmth that is there from the chili, but bahut kam. Bahut kam.
Balanced.
You can taste it just as a warm sort of a feeling on your tongue.
Well, it's first roasted and then it is braised in the gravy. It's a slow braise in the gravy.
I think that roasting also helps seal all the juices in.
The juices inside and then you braise it slowly. Until the time the meat just comes off easily. And that's what you see. Meat just comes off.
Very nice.
A little salad to cleanse your palate.
A little salad more than cleansing the palate for some fiber in between all the meat. But this is absolutely delicious.
It's got a good bite.
And especially on a hot day like today, I think a korma, sometimes can weigh you down. Whereas this dish is quite sprightly, utha deta hai. It's a sort of dish that picks you up, if you know what I mean. Biryani has been on the table for a few minutes now while we were relishing the kebab and the Chengezi chicken, that there is still some steam emanating. For me, chef, when I taste a biryani, it's always a rice first.
It's not like our basmati rice. This is
Sela rice. Definitely, you were tasting the flavor of the aromac. I think the screw pine or the kevda in some form. Really,
this has more of a lamb and the yakni flavor. You know, when they're cooking lamb along with the onion, barista, ginger, garlic.
Yeah.
Look at English, they cook rice.
Each grain is separate. Chilla hua hai
pura. That's the quality of this chilla rice.
Hmm.
Stay like this.
So the rice doesn't have any aroma. Even the flavor of the rice is.
It absorbs the flavor of the meat and the curry and the masalas.
In this, I'm tasting more the flavor of the fat.
Fat and masala.
Masala bahut halka hai. Bahut halka hai.
Rice ka apna flavor nahi hota isme.
Hmm.
Aur yahan pe old element is what you get.
That meat is
soft.
Soft and moist.
And it has a bite as well.
So this is a pakki akni pulao. Pakki akni biryani.
The lamb is cooked separate, almost 3-4 done, and the rice is cooked separate, then they combine.
Then it's layered.
Then they combine. Like Hyderabadi biryani, this biryani won't have a gravy kind of thing which is created.
And then the masala.
Yes. No. This will have mutton which is just cooked in its own juices and onion with the garlic.
Which is basically braised in that.
In that basic liquor, you add the rice on top and then you put it on.
So to me, I find the flavors in this mutton biryani quite gentle. And what you're tasting really is mostly the flavor of the meat. I think the spices here play a pure complementing role. What you're tasting is the flavor of the meat.
It has a bit of heat, what is required. Otherwise, it will be too bland. So the garam masala powder, then use the black pepper, you know, it's coming through. It's not very hot where, you know, you don't get any taste of lamb.
What I'm a fan of, more than the rice, is the manner in which they cook their meat. The rice, I find, is okay. Like this rice, you cannot eat it by itself. You need the meat to give company.
Exactly, so, but that's what I said, this part, in old Delhi,
This
is the rice we use.
And why is that?
It's just a preference of the ease of cooking. Not that it's cheap rice, it's a long grain, thick grain, but it withstands the cooking process pretty well.
The quality of the meat is
A1. Very good.
Very good. So between the Chengezi and the mutton?
I like the sikh quite a bit. Chengezi is pretty good. This one, I mean, it's good. It's not bad, I would say, but it's not a star dish.
Yeah.
Today, maybe.
To me, the stars were the Chengezi. I think the Chengezi was a revelation. I never visualized a chicken preparation. Jab unhone naam bola Chengezi, I thought, okay, yaar, kuch gimmicky hoga, kuch to aayega, ek naam bada tha. Kabhi-kabhi hota hai na, wo naam bade aur darshan chote. But that wasn't the case here. I think that dish more than lived up to the name that they have given it. Although I really don't know still what that name means. They said it is named after Genghis Khan, the conqueror or the invader. Yeah, what I'm thinking is that some of this. I think I need to liven up this rice. And I think that's where that Chengezi gravy will certainly come into play. Meko ye rice thoda sa, I mean if I may, I found it a little too mild, slightly pika, but ye Chengezi gravy ke saath.
Lucknow biryani aap
khayenge,
to uska jo yakhni hota hai, bahut light aur delicate hota hai,
Yeah.
उसके साथ थोड़ा सा रायता ले सकते हैं थोड़ा
सा, वो उसमें दूध भी डलता है ना।
यही अब हैदराबादी बिरयानी अगर आप खाते तो आपको पता है
हैदराबादी बिल्कुल
है। सालन उसमें भी सालन डालते हैं, मिर्ची का
कच्ची अखनी डबल मसाला वो रिवाज है।
बिरयानी है ये अलग है, द राइस हैज अ मॉइस्टनेस, इट हैज अ गुड सीजनिंग एंड आई फील पेपर, आई फील गरम मसाला, बट यस व्हाट इट लैक्स इज प्रोबब्ली लिटिल मोर फ्लेवर ऑफ मीट वुड हैव हेल्प्ड।
इफ यू ईट द राइस विद पीसेस ऑफ द मीट द मटन मीट यू विल फाइंड नथिंग लैकिंग। बट यू नो वेन यू आर ऑर्डरिंग अ बिरयानी, अगर आपने हाफ ऑर्डर किया तो बस आपको दो पीस मिलेंगे, उसमें चावल तो बहुत ज़्यादा होगा। सो देर शुड बी अ टाइम वेन यू आर एन्जॉइंग दैट राइस ऑन इट्स ओन बिकॉज यू हैव नो मीट रिमेनिंग। आई थिंक दैट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ अ गुड बिरयानी राइस, वेदर इट्स इन अ कच्ची अखनी स्टाइल हैदराबादी बिरयानी और अ लखनऊी पुलाव और अ कोलकाता आलू के साथ जो बनाते हैं और समथिंग लाइक दिस, right?
I get your point.
Because the rice is
what eating rice on its own.
Huh.
It should be flavorful on its own. You should not eat. Nothing should be required on
that. Correct. Like this Changezi gravy. But I'm but I'm quite happy because I'm getting to taste that gravy again. Yeah. We've taken a bit of a break from our food tour just to go somewhere quieter.
Charge our batteries.
Spend some time away from that noise, shor, sharaba,
mattress,
and come back a little energized. नहीं वहाँ पे वो खाने देंगे ये ये जो अच्छा लग रहा है जायका शौक फरमाइए। Fantastic. So what are we tasting, Amit?
So Kripal, we stopped by this beautiful shop. He's making Shahi Shirman.
हाँ जी निजामुद्दीन।
हाँ काफी मशहूर है। असल में मुझे इसके बारे में पता नहीं था तो we were passing by so we saw this and his product looks wonderful. So he makes these shirmal which are soaked in ghee and with different toppings. इसमें मैदा है और सूजी भी है और it's a very rich dough.
Some ghee, some khoa.
And then it's soaked in ghee.
Very rich. It's like a biscuit. Thanda
yeah,
biscuit
it's like a soft cookie. So thande hote hote crisp ho jayega.
Chai ke saath khalo, waisi hi khalo.
Ji, khoa ke saath, dali ke saath.
Bit of a powderiness to the...
It's like a suji.
Haan.
Isme jo thoda sa cardamom hai. Aur jo balance hai sugar ka, wo bahut badhiya hai.
Suji kitna hota hai?
10%.
Maida zyada.
होता है,
बेसन कितना जाता है?
बेसन मैक्सिमम 12-20%।
और दूध?
दूध आपका ये 7 लीटर जाता है।
7 लीटर कितने किलो में?
20 kg।
20 kg में और फिर खोआ जाता है।
तो बेसिकली गूंदना जो है, जो डो जो बना है वो दूध से बना है,
घी और दूध में,
घी और दूध में बनता है।
So,
पानी डलता है।
So there's also some yeast that goes into it to basically allow it to ferment. So it basically ferments for a day before they dock it and put all the nuts on it. And then it goes into that tandoor to bake and then comes out and gets immersed, dipped in some ghee, and after which it is cooled under the fan there, and then it's packed by Mr. Harshad Khan in these silver foils.
Aur kitna sundar lag raha hai dekhiye,
yeah,
ram kitna acha laga hua hai aur ye.
It's a sort of tea that immediately picks you up.
And that's the butter chicken of Rani Delhi.
आप इसको बटर में मक्खन में निलाते हो चिकन को
बिल्कुल। If you'd like to support the work that we do at Food Lovers TV, do consider joining our membership community on YouTube by hitting the join button below or on the homepage. You could pledge a nominal sum and receive special privileges like behind the scenes footage, shoot updates, access to live Q&As and a lot more. You could support us on a Patreon page as well. For more info, check out the links in the description below. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and leave a comment below. Happy eating!